Hi, welcome dear students. Hope you are doing good. Today I am going to explain some important questions. First one, what is an IP address? IP stands for Internet Protocol. Protocol means set of rules. So an internet protocol address is a numerical level assigned to each device connected to a computer network. So here you can see in the image IP address separated by dots. So it consists of four decimal numbers and each ranging from 0 to 255. That's true. And example 172.16.254.1. So any range between from 0 to 255 and separated by dots. So IP address is always a unique number. So it never be same, two IP address never be the same. So an IP address is a unique set of numbers used to give name to the IP address so that the user can locate a computer by a name. So every computer which is connected with a network uses an unique IP address. For example, the roll number of the student is unique all over the class. That's true. Next, what is DNS? DNS is domain name server. A special computer DNS is used to give name to the IP address so that the user can locate a computer by name. So every domain name uses a IP address. For example, domain name google.com, flipkart.com, and it has also an unique IP address. So a particular IP address to uniquely identify the computer on which the website is hosted. Now, next point, what is digital footprints? Digital footprints. When we are talking about digital footprint, you know, when you walk on a sand and you look behind, you see your footprints in the sand. No. Similarly, a digital footprint is the impression or information about a person on the internet because of his online activity. Okay. The information gets logged in database, and a digital footprint is also known as digital dossier. So basically, a digital footprint can be divided into two sections. First, passive and active. What is passive? Passive digital footprints is a data collected without the owner knowing, without the owner knowing. Whereas active digital footprints are created when personal data is released deliberately by user for the purpose of sharing information about oneself. For example, when you are going to upload images on a website, or when you are going to comment on the social media, okay, so all these information are stored in a database. So this is the example of the active. While you are going to email, chats, using chat, Facebook, and blog post. So are some other ways with which user creates active digital footprints. And passive data traces are generated by others or gathered through the user online activities without his knowledge. Understood? So I hope you understood what is the digital footprints. Next one. What is software piracy? Software piracy is the act of copying and distributing copies of software illegally. So usually you need a license or a copyright to copy an original software. So we are doing software piracy when we purchase a software, a single license, and install it on several computer. Okay, when you purchase a single licensed copy and install it on several computers, so this is also known as soft lifting. Another example, we make copies of the copyrighted software and distribute them. So this is also example of the software. So always we should always buy a licensed copy of a software and follow the terms and conditions of the license for each software product you purchase. So never make copies and circulate them. When you are going to purchase a single game CD and distribute among your friend, so this is the example of software piracy. I hope you understood what is software piracy. Next one is, what is the meaning of isolating a file? Isolating. So isolating means quarantine. Quarantine means isolating a file so that it cannot affect the system. No. So quarantine facility removes and isolates suspicious file into a safe location before analyzing them for possible infection. No. So whenever going to scan your computer using antivirus software detect viruses, no. So it also has a quarantine facility. So any files transferred in this fashion are encrypted. You know what is the meaning of the encrypted and readable format? Meaning they cannot be run or executed. No. So this isolation prevents infected files from affecting the rest of your PC. So if the file cannot be disinfected, then it provides a reliable safe house until the virus database is updated. So I hope the quarantine, why it is important isolating a file. Next point, least computing ethics. Computing ethics means behavior, you know, how we behave in society. Behavior or individual in a society. So computer, to use a computer, ethics can be defined as a set of principles related to the application of ethical principle, you know, to use of computer technology. So common ethical guidelines which all computer users must follow when using a computer. So we must not use a computer to harm other people. Also, don't interfere with other people's computer work. And don't use a computer to steal information. Also, never use a computer to bear false witness. So always use a computer in ways that ensure consideration and respect for your fellow humans. So never try to comment on the Facebook or social media network so that it harms the another people image, you know. So you must think before going to use. I hope you understood the least computing ethics. Thanks for watching.